This is a video to record the project I've completed over the last 9 months with these two crawlers. This is a Cletrac. It hadn't been going for 30 years. I still note the dirt on it from when it was parked up many years ago for some unknown reason. This one hadn't been going for 10 years. It had been used on a farm to tow the fencing trailer around. Peter Gray went down with his high urban truck, picked them up for us. Both of these tractors weren't going. This is the Oliver being loaded onto the truck after being towed out of the shed. This next slide is the Cletrac having been towed out of the shed. In the same shed with it was this old drill. It hadn't been going for so long that there was plants growing out from in it. We were lucky enough to get a tandem trailer load of spare parts to go with these crawlers. Some of them have been very useful, especially the injector pump. This is the wool shed, and my mates who come to help me pick up these bulldozers. The one at the front was actually going, and another gentleman in our club has had that one. These are the two that I got that weren't going. Note the beautiful New Zealand bush in the background. The guy in the middle is Andrew Gaston. He is the son of the late Murray Gaston, who owned these bulldozers. And this is the Oliver that was going with the fairly good grouses being unloaded first. These are the two crawlers at home in my shed with my farmer H. This is my son Alex. Oliver for Christmas and New Year. Dairy cows in the background. Neighbours. There's a lot of work going into this Oliver before the water pump completely cleaned out fuel system, fuel filters. So I have attached the solenoid and proper battery leads, and just seeing if we can pump diesel through the injectors.
The old one was seized. Only two working, so I've changed it over.
This is the Oliver with the vintage tractor pull on the old sleeve. And there was another crawler there which managed to get first place. second. I'll be back next year. Here are the three crawlers parked up at the tractor club, tractor pull. This one is the Oliver with its primer coat on before being painted.
Right, the primer went on last week. Here is the first coat of the yellow. Don't look too closely. Won't give up my day job and be a spray painter. But
build the US as the English guys.
Good to see you. We've been coming together inch by inch. This one is going to be orange. This is the Cletrac. And there's the dog.
This is the Oliver after the second coat of paint. Got a Oliver temperature gauge on Amazon from America. Here it is, looking pretty good. I still haven't got the stickers on it yet. It might be. The Cletrac had these cracks in the back spokes, but I did manage to weld them up, and they seem to be holding with a arc weld and a proper rods. This is the Cletrac in bits. I had to get a new seat pan put on it, and I raised the seat up a bit because you couldn't fold yourself into it. I took the top off the gearbox because the gears were very hard to shift, still are, although it didn't look too bad and the oil was clean. A little bit of rust from sitting around for 30 years, but a pretty good order really. I'm just hoping that it'll come right with a bit of work. The radiator was just holding on by the hoses. Fixed that up, put a new temperature gauge on this too, stripped off the paint. This is the paint that I used, just bought locally. Did read somewhere that you could get them in either orange or yellow from the manufacturer when they were built, so it only seemed fair to paint one of each colour. The Cletrac had been painted yellow in the past, but underneath there was orange, and that must have been its original colour.
Engine start.
that's about it. Still need to put the stickers on, and I'm getting the seat cushions made up. And the next video will be a moving video, showing them both going. But that might be a little way off yet. Thanks for watching.